If you think the MCU timelines and stories, etc. are confusing, lol, try the X-Men on for size. Hey guys, my name is Sucharita, this is Film Companion, you are watching Not A Movie Review, and right now I am not going to be reviewing Dark Phoenix.
She's coming.
The story begins in 1975 with a young Jean Grey. Due to circumstances a little out of her control, an 8-year-old Jean comes to stay and learn at the Charles Xavier School for Gifted Youngsters. Cut to 1992. A spacecraft is in trouble and the words, "Houston, we have a problem," are uttered because apparently dialogue writers really like making astronauts say that. Anywho, X-Men spring into action and you find out then ki Jean Grey ki powers kya hai and exactly what she's capable of. The rest of the film is her trying to come to terms with her changing self, going through a physical and mental metamorphosis and trying to decide ki ye nayi shakti se good karna hai ya evil. While everybody around her is realizing, holy shit, ye Captain Marvel ki amma hai bro. Dekho kya hai, Logan nikal de agar, to X-Men First Class ke baad koi achhi X-Men ki movie aayi nahi hai. And I'm not counting Deadpool here because that's a whole different thing. Apocalypse, if you remember, was astonishingly bad ki mujhe sirf itna yaad hai feeling bad for Oscar Isaac who had to play an embarrassingly dumb supervillain. Dark Phoenix mein, at least the good thing is that the story progression focuses on this one important character and the universe moves forward and develops along with her story. But idhar bhi, antagonist itna vague hai that you're never rooting for the main character with all your heart. Jessica Chastain plays the leader of an evil alien race who are after the force Jean possesses because that has the power for them to resurrect their own people. Now, I am not a comic book reader, just like most of the audience going in to watch the film, so if you tell me this description, evil shape-shifting alien के अलावा कुछ आगे बताओगे नहीं कि क्या प्लैनेट है, कैसे रेजरेक्ट होएगा, शेप शिफ्टिंग के अलावा क्या पावर है इन लोगों की, क्या पूरी रेस ही गुंडों की बनी हुई है, तो मुझे सपने आएंगे कि ये लोग कौन है. सुपर हीरो जानरा में जरूरी होता है टू रियली टिप द स्केल्स इन द विलन्स फेवर, क्योंकि जब लगता है कि बॉस इस बंदे से तो कोई जीत ही नहीं सकता, एंड देन व्हेन द सुपर हीरो हैचेस अ प्लान जिसमें सारी छोटी छोटी स्ट्रेंथ्स एक साथ मिलाकर एक जगरनॉट बनाता है व्हिच डिफीट्स द विलन्स, that's when you feel like, damn, this person is a superhero. Here, ek to you don't know anything about the villain. Upar se Jean is constantly and totally more powerful than anybody else right from the moment go, so you have no sympathy for her. And also, she's a bit of an ass. You know what I like about the X-Men movies is that they're always a team, stronger together. When they're living and learning at the X-Mansion or facing off bad guys with their individual powers all pooled in, that's something this film delivers on. There are two very, very cool fight sequences, one which happens around New York Central Park and one in a moving train. While in one scene, superheroes are fighting against each other and in another, they're united against a common enemy, but in both, you see excellent choreography, Hans Zimmer's music soars and sab apni apni superpowers ko use karte hai old-fashioned style. It's edge of the seat stuff. Oof, Michael Fassbender. He's shown in absolutely new surroundings, living a life we haven't seen Magneto live before. He's looking leaner and fitter and just so delightfully menacing, and man, when he uses his powers, focusing on mutilating his opponents in the best, most effective way possible, he's just the sexiest thing God Almighty ever created. Thank you. James McAvoy is in three superhero universes as of right now. X-Men, the M. Night Shyamalan trilogy, and Mr. Tumnus in Narnia. Lol. He's doing more of what we've already seen him do countless times as Professor X. I'm trying to help you, save you, listen to me. Yes, we get it. You're an egoistic but a kind-hearted man who makes wrong decisions sometimes. And this film doesn't let him try a whole lot of new stuff. Same for Jennifer Lawrence as Mystique. Though she does remind Professor X ki yahan hum aurtein hi sabki jaan bacha rahi hai. X-Women naam rakh do team ka. Lol. Sophie Turner as Jean Grey is weirdly frigid. Something I felt about her performance in Apocalypse as well. As a woman who's constantly just about to fall apart because she doesn't know what to do with herself. This part had so much scope to become epic, legendary even. But sadly, it doesn't even get halfway there. So, matlab, watch the film if you really want to keep up with this universe. But as a standalone motion picture, Dark Phoenix has very little to offer. So, on a scale of 1 to 10, Dark Phoenix is... 15,000 jobs were created through the making of this film. Aisa screen pe likha aata hai instead of an end credit scene. Oh yeah, don't bother. Nahi hai end credit. Mereko bata hai, this week you're on our YouTube channel only to hear about Bharat. To subscribe kar lijiye. Uska bhi video aa gaya hai. Dekh lo.